So what is sulfur? Sulfur is found elementally in minerals, ores, coal, mineral springs, and volcanic regions. It's also found and recovered from natural gas, crude oil, and large underground deposits, which would be sulfur mining. Sulfur is present in natural gas primarily as H2S, but there are also many other sulfur compounds that may be present, like mercaptans, sulfides, and disulfides. Liquid sulfur exists as S8 and exhibits very usual viscosity behavior, unusual viscosity behavior, which we'll look at on the next page. So sulfur's melting point is 120 degrees Celsius, and after it melts at that temperature, it continues to drop in viscosity until about 300 degrees Celsius, and that's when you see it jump up and quickly becomes very viscous, like a gum-like substance. And then just before it hits 400 degrees Celsius, it'll start to slowly decrease in velocity again and continue at that negative trend. So the industry. Commercialized sulfur production began in 1894 via Frasch mining and extraction process. Today, the sulfur industry is an integral part of the world economy, and it's a reliable indicator for a country's industrial activity. Sulfur is a vital resource used to manufacture a myriad of essential products. Sulfuric acid is used in mining, fertilizers, and potash, as well as pulp and paper. The fertilizer industry uses more than half of the sulfur production, converting most of it into sulfuric acid, into process agents such as phosphates, ammonium phosphates, and ammonium sulfate. Newer sulfur products include sulfur extended asphalt, sulfur concrete, and sulfur as a direct soil additive. And this table is for Alberta recovery guidelines, where the regulatory body is the Alberta Energy Regulator, or AER. The U.S. has an Environmental Protection Agency, or EPA, where each state has its own specific regulations for the sulfur industry. And these recovery licenses will dictate the minimum overall recovery efficiency, but they also regulate values for max SO2 emissions from the stack. And stack guidelines can be for SO2 tonnage or for concentration. But these licenses are based on the maximum SRU plant inlet in terms of sulfur tonnage. So our SRU feed streams. All refinery and gas plant process gas streams that contain H2S are routed to an amine unit for removal. Amine units capture H2S in an absorber or contactor and then release it in a regenerator or stripper in the form of acid gas. And this contains H2S, CO2, and hydrocarbon contaminants. And we hope that the upstream amine unit can minimize these contaminants before they send it to the SRU. All refineries also have a sour water stream, and this is routed to a sour water stripper, which removes H2S and NH3, which is ammonia. Sour water strippers include a regenerator or stripper, which removes H2S and NH3 from solution in the form of acid gas. And this acid gas stream contains approximately equal parts of H2S, NH3, and H2O, as well as other trace contaminants, which we hope to be minimized.